Hey everybody, it's Lego Jang here with, as promised, the next in my series of shooty space things. I started on just the base, just the bottom platform and the wheel alignment of this when I did my light personal assault tank mock and the video for that. And now I have completed it to my satisfaction for now. I will probably make adjustments later on, but for now, this is it. This is what you get with it, and I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. Matter of fact, I'm gonna take a really quick break right here and go grab the light tank. Okay, so as you can see them side by side, this was the first one that I did, and here's the next one. So you can just see in the comparison in size. One is a light tank, one is a medium tank, and it just kind of fits with the overall look. Everything about this one is larger, it's wider, it's a little bit taller. I mean, even if you don't consider the guns up here, but the guys sit higher up, and it's just, you know, everything is scaled up, and the functionality is scaled up as well. So focusing on this one, obviously two people, one is a driver up front, and then the one in the back, he has a radar dish and also a heads-up display. He's the gunner, so he controls this twin high-powered laser turret, which can turn, it can rotate around. As a matter of fact, can it go all the way? Yes, it can rotate all the way around, and within a 180-degree arc, just from here to here, it can also shoot or angle all the way up like so. So it can actually attack, track and attack things in the air. So air-based enemies just from here to there. Just can't go all the way because, you know, it hits the guy in the back, but you can go to here. And that's a pretty decent range. The radar dome is right here. So that's where he's getting his readings from. And then you've also got these sensors over on the side, optical and probably infrared tracking through this unit off to the side, and just did a few random little things to add a little bit of texture down around the base. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with this thing. It's what I wanted out of the whole thing to begin with. When I first thought of it, I wanted very much to use two people in it, and I wanted it to have larger guns, like as if, you know, there's a whole series of different standard guns that are available in the arsenal of these Earth people or whatever. The one thing that I don't like here is that some of these parts are old gray, so old light gray. You can see that they're a little bit yellowish compared to the so-called bluish gray or light bluish gray that we use nowadays. So a little bit of mix and match on the light gray colors there, simply because I was just using parts that I had on hand, and some of the parts that I have are still older stuff. Over time, as I get new parts, I will be able to get rid of some of the old stuff, some of the old colors completely, just abolish them, just remove them from my collection, and then I'll be able to come back with mocks that use those older colors and just replace the parts so that they'll be more consistent. Now, there was one little trick that was done here. I did some sideways building. That was required in order to get this center axle where it is, halfway between these two, because I needed to move two-thirds? Looks like a little more than two-thirds of a peg out. No? Yeah, I think that's right. Because this piece right here that puts the pin through sideways actually is almost centered. So it's just about two-thirds forward or one-third back from where it would have been had I just used another one of these pieces here, again with the older gray, this old dark gray, but just going directly into the lugs just didn't work. So I did a little sideways building just to center that up. I am using different wheels here because I ran out of this type of wheel, but I'm okay with that because these would represent drive wheels, so it actually makes sense for them to potentially be different. But that's it. That's it for this one. I just wanted to show that to you guys, and we'll be doing more in the future. So thanks for watching. Please be sure to watch the main blog for more updates. Not everything that I post up is a video on YouTube, so there's some stuff that'll show up there that won't show up on the video channel. LegoJang.com is where you can find all the stuff that I'm doing with Lego nowadays. And yeah, I'll be talking to you again soon.